हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम अमित मित्तल फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग। नाउ आई एम कंटिन्यूइंग द ऑब्जेक्टिव 11 ऑफ ओओपी लैब, राइट प्रोग्राम्स टू अंडरस्टैंड एक्सेप्शन हैंडलिंग टेक्निक्स। आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग द कॉन्सेप्ट्स फॉर रीथ्रोइंग एन एक्सेप्शन एंड स्पेसिफाइंग एक्सेप्शन। रीथ्रोइंग एन एक्सेप्शन कैन बी रीथ्रोन विदाउट प्रोसेसिंग इट फर्स्ट। An exception is rethrown using the statement throw semicolon without any arguments. This causes the current exception to be thrown to the next enclosing try catch sequence and is caught by a catch statement listed after that enclosing try block. Next concept is specifying exceptions. It is possible to specify only certain types of exceptions that we want to throw, catch, and handle in our program. This is done by specifying those certain types of exceptions in the function definition. The general form of an exception specification is type, function, argument list, throw, exception type. The exception type specifies the type of exception that can be thrown by that function. Throwing any other type of exception will cause abnormal program termination. If we want that a function should not throw any exception, then in the above format of exception specification, the exception type should be empty. That is, type, function, argument list, throw, and then the empty pair of parentheses. Now, I will be discussing the implementation of these concepts. I am using a text editor for making the program. And for implementing the program, you can use any compiler like GCC compiler or Dev C++ compiler. Now the first topic is write program for rethrowing an exception. Here a main function is defined, then there is a try catch block in the main function, and then in the definition of a function, the try catch block is there. Let us discuss the working of this program. The program execution starts with main function, then cout top of main. This will be the output, first output top of main. Then try block will be executed, fun 16. So this 16 will be passed into x1, then the next output will be top of fun. Then try block of function fun will be executed, try throw x1. So 16, that is the integer exception is thrown, and this will be caught by the catch block, catch int x2. So the output will be exception caught x2, and in x2 we have 16. So exception caught 16, then throw semicolon. So the current exception, that is the integer exception, is rethrown, and this rethrown exception will be caught by the outer try catch block. So it will be caught here in the outer try catch block in the main catch, so exception recaught 16. So the next output will be exception recaught 16, then bottom of main, and our program is terminated here. The next program is write program for exception specification to restrict a function to throw certain exceptions only. Here the main function is defined. In the main function, there is a try block is there. In this, the function is called. Then the catch block is defined two times. Then there is a function definition of function fun. Then in this definition of function, if else block is there. Let us discuss the working of this program. Program execution starts with main function. Then fun 1. 1 will be passed as an argument. Here, see that we are writing void fun int throw int. That is, we are restricting the function fun to throw integer type of exception. So, when the function is passed with the argument 1, so if x is equal to 1, throw character x. So, a character exception is thrown. But we have already restricted our function that it can throw only integer exception. As here a character exception is thrown, so we get the output as terminate called after throwing an instance of char. The next program is write program to specify nil exception to be thrown by a function. Here in the function signature we write void fun throw then the empty pair of parentheses because we want that nil exception to be thrown by the function. The program execution starts with main function. The function fun is called. Then in the function definition void fun throw empty pair of parentheses then throw 12 that is an integer exception is thrown here but we have already specified that in our program nil exception should be thrown. So as integer exception is thrown so the output will be terminate called after throwing an instance of int. That's all.